Hey everybody, in today's tutorial, I am going to be showing you how to cut a wig. First of all, like most of my other things, what I do is a little bit different from what other people do when they're cutting into a wig. I'll go ahead and explain why when I get there. But for starters, what I'll be doing and what I would suggest you also do is have a setup of how you want it to look. So the wig that I am going to be working on is Franziska von Karma from Phoenix Wright. Sorry, my brain isn't working today. And I have a reference art of hers so that I can kind of see how it looks so that I can cut it a little bit easier. But I have already parted the top of the wig and I kind of have it clipped in the back. Over on the other side, I have the first section clipped and then the next part draped over just so that I have a good view of how I want it to look. From here, what I'm going to be doing is just using a pair of small scissors. Personally, I'm a fan of smaller scissors compared to any larger scissors just because it's easier to make smaller snips. My hands don't wear out as quickly, and in general, I feel like I have more control with this little guy compared to these guys. So I would always suggest just getting a small, good pair of scissors just when you're doing some trimming or cutting of a wig. It's just easier that way. Another thing is to just have some rat tail combs and just regular combs also so that you could do the styling. And I'm just going to go ahead and start jumping right into this. And what I'll just be doing is cutting some bangs. Now, everybody tells me that the first time that they cut a wig, it is completely horrifying because you know that once you cut it, you can't do anything to fix it if it's too short. If it's too long, yeah, you could do something about that, but still. A lot of people are always scared about the first cut. My personal suggestion is just do it. There's no other easier way of putting it. Just go ahead and put in your first cut. Now, if you are nervous about the first cut and either doing it too short or you're just scared in general, if you want the bangs to end here, cut it maybe down here so that you have a little bit of playroom and so that you could kind of test it out and view how it actually looks. So what you do is just hold on to it. If you notice, my hand slid down because I'm still always nervous about my first cuts also. But you just pull it down and then just start doing smaller snips across it. And I just have a trash can right below the wig so that I could just toss it immediately and then I don't have to worry about any of the excess hair, which, I'll be honest, wig hairs can be a little bit itchy against skin, so be prepared for that if you're not used to that, or in general, just be prepared to have a trash can down below or a vacuum or change clothes once you're done. Now, I'm still thinking that these bangs are just a little bit too long for this section, so I'm just going to go ahead, grab it a little bit higher, and snip again. Alright, that looks a little bit better, because Franziska has all of the bangs over here. I'll probably do maybe just a little bit more cutting, but right now I think I'll be okay. Now, if you notice on the edge of the bangs, they're very straight cut. You could obviously tell that they were freshly cut. What I like to do, and this is where I'm a little bit different from other people, is I will take my small scissors and start cutting at an angle. This is, again, why I have a trash can literally down below. And you just do this angle cut throughout the entire thing, little snips, nice and simple. And then I take the scissors, start the other angle, and start cutting into it. This is similar to what hairstylists do when they cut real hair and they're just trying to feather it. Is they just do these little snips because then it kind of gives the hair a more realistic, natural, oh, it grew this length. It's kind of nice in that sense. So now that I've got these two sections done, I'm just going to go ahead and check and see. If I do it that way, yeah, they're still looking good for the character. And then you just go into the next section. I will rarely grab an entire section of a wig and just cut it right off. I like working smaller sections at a time, there's less chance of making mistakes in that sense, and it just kind of gives me a little bit more balance. So this is a really good base off on how to do some cutting. If you're still a little bit worried, practice first on a wig that you don't mind getting rid of, or something that you know that all you're going to be doing is cutting a few inches off of it. But start simple. The more complex you go, take your time with it, and you should be all right. Good luck, you guys.